One, two, and two.
Good evening, everyone.
Yeah.
It's lovely to thank you, Anne. And thank you, Pastor Jason, for having me. And thank you to my wonderful drummer as well. I hope he's going to be wonderful anyway. If not, I'll give him a clip over the euro. It is really lovely to be with you tonight. If you don't know me or have never met me before, some of you know me very well. One of you has known me all of your born days. That's my sister. She's known me for a very long time. And she's here tonight, my brother-in-law, which is gorgeous. So my name is Sarah. I'm a Swansea girl originally. Boo, hiss. I know. And now I live in Cornwall, in sunny Cornwall. We've been there for 17 years. They let me back to Wales every now and again. And it is absolutely lovely to be with you tonight. I've got a dad who's in a nursing home in the area, my sister. So I come up every 6 weeks to visit family. And I was invited to do a hymn evening here tonight with you. I think this is the third one that I've done in the last 6 months here, and I've probably done half a dozen down in Cornwall, and everybody seems to really enjoy it. So I hope that you relax and really enjoy this evening. There's no pressure. You may not know all of the songs. Don't go, oh, don't know this one. The whole point of this evening is also that you might think, I didn't know that one, but aren't the words lovely? Or I didn't know that one, but I really liked it. I did know that one from like 30, 40, 50 years ago. Can some of you go back that far? No. Okay. However many years back, you think, gosh, when was the last time we sang that? So I just want tonight to be really relaxed and a real sense of family and fellowship and we will smile and we will rejoice, and you can stand or you can sit. There is no rules and there's no pressure. I just want you to leave tonight saying to yourself, I'm really, really glad I went. Yeah. Right? It's always good when we gather together. Even sometimes you think, oh, I really need to force myself to go. It is always really good when we gather together, whenever that is. It's always beneficial. It's always the right thing to do, to sing praises to God. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. The psalmist says, in the good days and the bad days and the difficult days and the wonderful sunny days, his praise will continually be in my mouth. So I love the hymns myself. I lead worship in my church every few weeks. I love the modern worship songs, and I love the hymns. And I often use a hymn as part of my worship, and I love playing the hymns at home on my piano all of the time. And at the start of COVID, when we were in lockdown and we were at home a lot, I started playing the hymns from the Red Book, and I started recording them. I recorded 3 or 4, then I did another 4 or 5, then I did another dozen. Now I've done 640. I haven't done any cleaning or housework or nothing for 3 years. I've recorded 640. And I started off with all the ones that we know and that are very familiar. And the more I've dug into this, the more treasure I found. It's like a treasure chest. And some of these hymns are inspired straight from the scriptures. And the hymns were written to teach us all about God and for our theology and our knowledge of God to thrill our hearts and our souls. So I pray that that will happen to you tonight. We're not going to do all 640. There's 800 in your altogether. I know, we're not going to do all 800. But how do we even begin to choose which ones we are going to do? So I've got a list. I also want to give opportunity for you to choose something that might be really special to you. You can't all have your choice, but if you, during the evening, have a little flick through, there may be one that is we really, really need to do. I want to give you a chance to do it, okay? So shall we start with something that most of us will know, I think. Shall we start with Blessed Assurance? Because that's our old favorite. Number 370. 370, Blessed Assurance. Maybe you want to stand and stretch your legs at the start, shall we? If you're able, get some breath in your lungs, and then you can stand or sit during the evening as you feel. But maybe we'll just give this a little bit of Welsh hoyl to start the evening off, shall we?
Just
wonderful. I wasn't going to start that habit of repeating choruses, otherwise we're going to be here all night. But sometimes you just got to do what you got to do. Do you know what I mean? This is my story. I don't know what your story is. I don't know what your journey is. I gave my heart to Jesus at the age of 12, grew up in a Christian family. That's my story. What's your story? We've all got a different story, haven't we? And this is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Right, let's drop into another nice, meaty, lovely 626. 626. Oh dear. 626. Who knows this one? Love lifted me when no one but Christ could help. Love lifted me. Wonderful. And then a pause at the end, and then we give it a bit of oomph. Ready, second verse. Souls in danger, look above. Jesus completely saves. We are living by his love. How could we have regrets? He's the master of the sea. In Moses still obey. Yeah. wonderful. Have a seat for a second. It's warm up here. Now, one of the things that I love to do, because this is possible, is I love swapping the words and the tunes of a hymn around. So there are some hymns that are very, the tune is very, very familiar, and that's the tune for that song. So you know that tune. What a friend we have. That's the tune for that hymn, and they belong together. But there are some tunes that also fit really nicely with other words. And during my journey the last few years, I've been doing a lot of swaps. So would you like to hear a few swaps? Okay, a few swapsies. Let's try then. Let's look at number 15. Number 15. Here we go. Number 15. We're going near the front of the book. It should be, "Oh, the deep, deep love of Jesus." Is that right? Okay. Now, how about doing it to this tune? Normally, it's this. Isn't it? Well, will you allow me to do it to this tune? Well, you haven't got a choice, because I'm doing it anyway. I'm doing it anyway. Okay, so we're doing it to this tune, which goes like this. Well, you tell me what this tune is. Love Divine, okay? So we're gonna do Love Divine tune to "Oh, the Deep, Deep Love of Jesus" words. Okay, and you see if you think it fits nicely. I think it does. I think it makes it sort of lift and come alive. Have a little, see what you think. Ready? Do you like it?
Yes.
Good. Because these are gorgeous, gorgeous words, aren't they? And singing it to a different tune, it just sometimes will feel a little bit different on the inside of us. Let's do the second verse, shall we?
Yeah.
wonderful. Isn't that nice? And I went, did you notice I went up a key for the last verse? I love doing that as well. Which you can't always do when you've got a full worship band because you've got music and you've got chords. But I haven't. It's only me and James. So I can get away with everything tonight. Going up a key again even. Because why not? I'm in the bont. Okay, let's do this one, number 197. This is a different tune as well, but you will know this tune. Absolutely guarantee you will know this tune, or you get your money back. Oh, we're not taking your money, okay? Number 197 should be Golden Harps Are Sounding. Now, this is a Francis Ridley Havergal hymn. Probably not very well known in some ways. It's about Jesus ascending back up to heaven to be with his Father after his work on earth was complete. But we will do it to this tune. Who knows what this tune is? Bob been seen Fadlon and Cymraeg, Ife, Tamil Bach, Abertawe, see, so Tamil Bach. Okay, so we are doing Golden Harps Are Sounding to the tune of Bob been seen Fadlon. So when we get to the chorus. You look at you're chomping at the bit. Let's stand for this one, get a bit of air in our lungs, shall we? Okay, number 197. All about Jesus and the wonderful work that he did for us. Golden harps are sounding, angel voices ring.
Is on a pinch on you to destroy.
seat. Yes, please. Oh, thank you. Boy, oh boy. Because I'm giving it oil. Wonderful. Right, let's have, I tell you what, let's have a song of your choice. Is there anybody here tonight with a favourite hymn? As long as we know it, or some of us know it, or most of us know it. Is there anybody here with a, I've got a list, so don't worry if you haven't. Or do you want to give it a few more minutes and then we'll come back to you? Or has anybody got one? Speak now or forever hold your peace. On the sound desk. 3-2-2. I've got on my list 3-3-2. Let's see what 3-2-2 is. Oh, nice. Lovely. Will your anchor hold in the storms of life? I live by the sea where I live in Cornwall. We live in a fishing village called Porthleven. It's often on the front page of the newspapers with the clock tower with the waves that come crashing over. And when was it? Must have been at least 6 or 7 years ago. We had a terrible storm and we watched boats sinking in the harbour. Literally, we watched them sink. We saw a car go in. Nobody in it, thankfully. That sunk. And all the well, 6 or 7 boats sunk. They were bashed around and they sunk. And it was awful for the community, you know. And sometimes, you know, in life, we go through storms, don't we? And sometimes sometimes we get a warning, don't we, with the weather people, that there's a storm coming and we can make adjustments in our homes, etc. But sometimes a storm comes unexpectedly and, whoa, it's a bit of a shock, isn't it? In life, sometimes unexpected and expected things. And we need an anchor. We need an anchor, don't we? We need the Lord Jesus Christ for the storms of life to keep our heart safe. When everything else shakes around us, we need an anchor, and his name is Jesus. I hope you know Jesus too, and the lovely Saviour that we're singing about tonight. I hope he is real to you in your storms, as they sometimes come. Ready for another one? Okay, right. Let's go for 3-3-2. So if you're still in that area, turn over the page. 3-3-2. Do you know this one? Years I spent in vanity. This always used to make me smile as a child. Sometimes the words of some of the hymns are quaint, aren't they? Years I spent in vanity and pride, caring not my Lord was crucified. But I know exactly what it means. It means that we may have spent years of our life just thinking about ourselves. Me, myself, and I. Caring not that the Lord was crucified and didn't even know it was for me. He died on Calvary. But then I discovered that mercy was great and grace was free and pardon was multiplied to me. Then my burdened soul found liberty at Calvary. So it tells a beautiful story, doesn't it, of what Jesus has done for us. Let's think of what key we'll do it in. Wonderful. Did you enjoy that? Oh, it tells a wonderful story, doesn't it, of perhaps how we were and how we are now and how our lives have changed. Right, do you want another hymn swap, tune swap, word swap thing? Let's do it. Number 378. And we're going to do it to, we normally would sing this tune. Less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. We normally would sing that tune. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. We're not going to do that tune. We're going to do this tune. We're going to do, the tune is this. What is this tune? So that's Eternal Father, Strong to Save. Well known as a naval hymn, isn't it, in the military. Wonderful words, but we're going to do these words to it. And let's see how we get on with that. Okay, let's try. Ready? My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. That lifts as well to the chorus, doesn't it? The chorus, it sort of goes up in a lovely crescendo. Let's try the second verse. It talks about the human experience, and it talks about that solid rock. When darkness seems to veil his face, I rest on his unchanging grace. In Nice, isn't it? Yeah. In the back of the music book, this is my music book. My husband's just fixed it for me last week because it had come apart from the cover. My grandmother bought me this for my 16th birthday. Now, that's a while ago, isn't it? Who was about to say that? Now, it's not, I think if I'd have bought something like this for, I've got four children, I think if I'd have bought them a hymn book for their 16th birthday, it might not have gone down so well. But I was thrilled to get this as a 16-year-old, and it's actually still in good, it's still in good shape. And in the back of the music book, there's something called metering, which is how a hymn is laid out, and that's where it gives you the suggestions of tunes that fit other words. So some of them I've discovered myself, and some of them are in the back of the book. There it is, look. If you're a music hymn book geek, it's all the ways that different hymns can be swapped around. So that's in the back of the music book. Right, have you noticed that many of the hymns, we saw it in this one actually, the last verse of many hymns points us to heaven. It talks to us about life. It talks to us about the challenges of life, but it doesn't leave us dangling without hope. Jesus will never leave us dangling without hope in this life, ever, will he? We've got his word, and we've got the fellowship that we have together. We've got the ability to worship. He'll never leave us without hope. And in so many hymns, the last verse will always point us to heaven. It's like as if it's saying, Charles Wesley is saying it, Isaac Watts is saying it, Fanny Crosby is saying it, they're all saying it. It doesn't matter how challenging life sometimes gets, don't one day you'll be in heaven. You'll be in a place where if you put your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, you'll be in a place where there's no more tears and no more pain. Who wants to be pain-free? Wouldn't that, for some of you that struggle with chronic pain, whether it's toothache or arthritis or chronic pain, one day we will be with the Lord where there's no more tears and no more pain and no more sorrow, no more sadness. Those things will be gone and we'll be in the presence of the Lord. And that's what I love about the hymns. They don't just talk about the storms of life. They talk about when the storms of life are finished, we've got heaven. We've got heaven to really look forward to. So let's sing. Let's sing a couple of hymns about heaven. Because if there's something that will cheer us all up tonight, it is singing about heaven. Let's do number 763. You will need to stand. You will. You will. If you're able. If you're able.
Let's go.
for you. Will you look out for me? I'll be wearing a bright green dress. Bright. I hope nobody suffers from migraines here tonight, because this is a little bit bright. I'm sorry. I went bright and cheerful tonight. Right, let's have a look at something. Let's go to number... Let's do something like number 345. So I've avoided what I would call the songs of praise hymns. Do you know what I mean by songs of praise hymns? Like, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven. Like, what else would you say is a songs of praise hymn? Love Divine. I've avoided some of the old classics. I've gone with sort of different type of hymns tonight. But let's have a little look at number 345. Maybe some of you, would you know it or don't know it? You don't know it at all? Oh, there's no point if nobody knows. I'm not singing a solo. Okay, and I'm not doing it. No, I'm not. Definitely not. Okay, let's try another one. Do you know 475? 475. Anybody know this one? No? Would you like to know it? This is one of the treasures that I found in this hymn book treasure chest fairly recently, and it really blessed me. So I think we will do it, if you don't mind, because I think the words will really bless you as well. Right, let me dig the music out just so that I know I'm doing it a bit right. A bit right. We'll try and do it a bit right. Oh dear. Talk amongst yourselves. 475. I think you will like this one. I like it. Pretty tune. Even if it's new to you, just let the words wash over you. And let's do the first verse again, just so that we get our heads around it, okay? Sweet is the promise, I will not forget thee. Love the modest, or turn my soul away. Into the night, be dark within the valley. I am not. Yes, we can do the chorus again. It'll cost you a fiver. I wanted to share that tonight and how it blessed me. I was around my piano just learning the notes and trying to get it right, and I'm thinking, oh, that the Lord says to all of us, I will not forget thee. I will not, you know, it's all in the old English, isn't it? I will not forget you. I will not leave you. He's promised to never leave us or forsake us. He says, I will not forget you. I've graven you in the palms of my hands, actually. You ain't going anywhere. You are mine. I will never forget you. I will never leave you. In my hands, I'll hold you. In my arms, I'll fold you. Proper kutch. Proper heavenly kutch. I will not forget thee or leave thee. I am thy redeemer. I will care for thee. It really blessed me that day. And the verses, and again, fourth verse, surprise, surprise, it's talking about heaven. And along the way, we have to do verse 2 and verse 3, which talks about how can I show my gratitude to Jesus? That's my service. And verse 3, how do I keep on track? By trusting in the promise that he will never leave me or forsake me. So I need verse 2 and verse 3, and I've got verse 4 to look forward to one day. It's a win-win, isn't it? When we're a Christian, it's a win-win. It's a win-win, because Jesus is with us every single day. Now, has anybody got a choice yet? 85. Lovely. Oh, nice. Lovely. Here is love vast as the ocean, loving kindness as the flood. Days, we normally only sing the first two verses and we stop, but the last two verses are absolutely gorgeous. I had this hymn, we had this hymn in our wedding all those years ago, 31 years ago, and I love the third verse and the fourth verse as much as I love number one and two. Absolutely gorgeous. Ready? Let me all thy love accept it.
Thank you.
thank you for that lovely choice. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you. Just catch your breath for a second while we have a little commercial break. Should we have a little commercial break? It's ITV tonight and not BBC, so we'll have a little commercial. So, as well as enjoying the hymns during COVID, I was able to finish a little project that I started a while ago of producing a book with a friend. It's a book that's called Pearls for the Girls. I don't know if you can see the slightly shiny cover. It's not just for ladies and ladies of all ages, but men could read it as well if they want to. It's basically lots of different individual thoughts for the day with a Bible verse and some illustration that my friend Mel did. So I did all the words and she did all the illustration, and we finished it during COVID and got it printed. And I've got some copies with me tonight. Christmas is coming, you know, it's September now. So it's time to start thinking about Christmas shopping. And tonight, you know, I'd love to help you with that. And so, no, seriously, if any of you are interested in having a look, they're £10, but they do make, I think they do make a lovely gift. I know somebody in a youth group in a church in Essex, they contacted me, they wanted 10 of these, and they're using them with teenage girls in a youth group, using them as discussion starters, and then doing a little study and an activity. So when there's one about apples, I talk about when our eldest son bit into an apple and it was brown, you know, and it was bruised. And I talk about somewhere from the supermarket to my fruit bowl, it had got hurt along the way and bruised. And I talk about sometimes we get bruised. And so I've done this little talky bit about being bruised and that story of my son Josh. And when they did that study in the youth group, they made toffee apples. Oh, I thought, that's good. So they learned, talked about, you know, when we get hurt in life, and they did a little tiny study all about it, opened it up for discussion, and then they made toffee apples. Good idea. Then I've also heard of somebody using it when they go into a care home to, they play a hymn, and they read one of these as a little gentle thought, because they're based on something from the Bible, but it's not heavy preaching. So you could stand wherever you are and read it, and it might be appropriate. So there's some of those. Then I've also got this. This was inspired because my dad, who I've come to visit the last couple of days, is in a nursing home. He's got quite advanced Alzheimer's. And I'm always looking for things to do with him when I'm with him. And I created this book, and then my husband said, you should make more of them. Other people would like them, and as gifts, etc. And so I did. It's a hardback book. It's hardback because it's easier to hold than paperback. And inside are, well, let's have a little look. Bible verses, well-known Bible verses, with a full-colour photograph, lovely big font. They are actually our sheep. My husband has got 15 sheep and lambs. We've got lambs. So that's one of his sheep. It's made it into the book. So underneath are the everlasting arms. We've been singing all about those sort of words today, haven't we? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth, Psalm 121. Rejoice in the Lord always, from Philippians. And again I say, rejoice. That's it, you're good, aren't you? You were so good. Trust in, right, see if you can finish this one off. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart, and don't lean on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your paths or make your path straight. Peace be still. So you get the idea. There's 40 pictures in there. My dad loves it, and we sit with him. He's got a very limited capacity. This is not just for someone with limited capacity. Perfect for someone who's getting baptized. Perfect for Christmas. Christmas is coming. £7.50. Just a nice gift. Nice just to have on your coffee table. For someone who's not very well, you've got the picture. It'll last longer than a bunch of flowers. And about the same price. There we are. Commercial over. So if you want to take a little bit of me home with you tonight, You can take a book. Right. Ready for another hymn? Shall we have a good old Pentecostal one? Like proper. Like proper, proper. Okay, 249 then. Let the fire fall. Oh, do you know this one or not? Oh, when was the last time you sang that? A month ago. Yes, I know. Apart from a month ago, it was a while before that, was it? No. Do you sing it? Oh my gosh, seriously? I thought you were winding me up, Anne. Brilliant. Absolute. Well, I think you might need to stand again. I think so.
Yeah.
Wonderful. You're in good voice tonight, aren't you? Gosh, nobody sings like the Welsh. But don't tell them that I said that down in Cornwall, okay? Because they think they can sing, but nobody sings quite like the Welsh. Right. Anybody else got a choice?
176.
I stand amazed in the presence. Yeah? I'm such a geek. 176. I stand amazed in the presence of Jesus the Nazarene and wonder how he could love me, a sinner condemned unclean. Last verse, surprise, surprise, talks about heaven. How many hymns do that? Isn't that wonderful? Gives us that glorious, glorious hope. And I don't think we can skip a verse. Sometimes we do 1, 3, and 5, don't we, to just get through it so we can get home and have our supper or our buffet. But this unfolds a story. We can't skip one of these verses. I'm really sorry. We have to do all 5. There are some hymns. I think it's And Can It Be That I Should Gain was written initially with 26 verses. So let's be grateful that this is 5, shall we? It's 5. Phew, I stand amazed.
Oh,
Gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous. Right. How are we doing for time? Couple more? Couple more? Yeah, lovely. Couple more. Right. Let's have a little look. Has anybody got anything burning? Burning, absolutely. Oh! I knew it was coming. 288. Oh, it's on my list. Brilliant. I knew that was coming. We couldn't not do that, could we? We couldn't go home without doing that. 288. Number 288, sorry. 288. Would you be free from your burden of sin? I think you're going to need to stand again. Up and down like yo-yos, bless you. Only if you want to and if you're able. I think, a great hymn of rejoicing as we begin our descent to arrive at our... Do you know this one? The head that once was crowned with thorn. We've talked about the power of Jesus' blood, and he died and he rose again, didn't he, to give us new life. I absolutely love, 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 love this hymn. I'm just trying to see what key it's in. do.
The head that once was crowned with thorns.
Yeah.
let's drop it too high. Yes. What is it? 631. Brilliant. 631. And there, this will be our final one. Honestly, now. Final. 631 is our final song, and we're going to end with this wonderful joy that Jesus walks with us and talks with us along life's narrow way. The final song, 631. Thank you tonight for all these wonderful hymns that we have sung, hymns that are so true in the depths of our hearts, hymns that we've sung perhaps for many years, or perhaps they're new to us, but our love for you is so beautifully expressed through these words. And thank you tonight that we have gathered to sing your praise. We have loved singing your praise, and we've loved being together. So thank you, Lord, for this hope that will resonate with us as we leave tonight, that you are alive, and you are with us, you walk with us, and you talk with us, along life's narrow way, and we will never despair, and we will never be lonely, and we will never be without hope, because we have you, Lord Jesus. And for that, we are so grateful and so thankful. We praise you and we thank you, and we lift up your wonderful name tonight.
Some have been written through struggles, some have been written through hardship and difficulties and battles. But Lord, we thank you because the one thing that they all have in common is our Jesus. We thank you, Lord, that the one thing that they can all offer us is hope. And so, Lord, this night we thank you for inspiring these hymn writers. Thank you, Lord, for speaking through them to us. And tonight, Lord, we thank you especially for Sarah, who has brought these hymns and played and sung so beautifully. We thank you for James. It's so good to see him where he belongs. And Father God, we just pray for everyone who's been present in this place tonight. We pray, Father God, that as we depart, that we will take with us your blessing. We thank you, Lord, that these words that we've sung can stay within our hearts. We don't need to leave them here. We can take them with us into all situations and all circumstances. And so, Lord, tonight, we just want to say from the bottom of our hearts, thank you, Lord, for saving our souls. Thank you, Lord, for making us whole. Thank you, Lord, for giving to us thy great salvation, so rich and so free. Pray a blessing, Lord, on all homes that are represented. We pray for travelling mercies for all those who have to travel. And we say thank you, Lord, for all that you've done, for all that you're doing, and for all that you are still to do in us and through us, in your lovely name.